everybody on edge here as the puck is dropped, and Besser will play it down into the Minnesota zone. JT Miller goes after it around the boards, and Nico Sturm out there to start. Can't clear. Scores! Chris Tanev from the point has a series winner for Vancouver.
Can you say, get a puck in deep, get a shot to the net. Brock Besser does a nice job, and off the faceoff, Miller and Koivu went at it a couple of times, and they kept chopping and whacking, and eventually smashes that puck on the faceoff over to Besser. And as the Canucks have done all night long when they've been behind, they've put pucks in and established that forecheck, and that's exactly what happens here. That is a huge goal for Tanev. And Travis Green with his first playoff series win as well.
Former handshakes of the coaches. Teammates.
Yeah.
Tanev's first ever Stanley Cup playoff goal. It comes 11 seconds in. And I'm going to let everybody know that 10 seconds before we came back on the air, Louis DeBrusse said, Tanev with a point shot to win it.
I just had a feeling, you know what, he's been all over it tonight. He's played a real sound defensive game, but again, I just felt it was going to take something like that to win this game, as both teams have been so defensively sound and battled throughout this series. That's a huge goal for Tanev.
Mikko Koivu skating there in your picture off the ice. Is this the last time we'll see him on an NHL stage? And as the guys mentioned in the intermission, Kevin Bieksa suggesting the team picked up Jacob Markstrom tonight. He had some terrific times in the series, but tonight the guys in front of him helped him out.
Real valuable point. And you know, when your goaltender gives up a couple goals that maybe he should want to have back, which there was definitely a couple tonight, the short side goals by Staal, and then you saw the one later on in the game by Sturm, his first ever goal in the National Hockey League. You knew that the motivation was there for the Canucks to come back and drive the pace of the game, and they've done that all game long. They've been behind a few times in this game. They found a way to tie it up each and every time. Push it to overtime, give yourself a chance, and the huge goal by Tanev. Here it is right here. Besser puts it in deep, the aggressive forecheck by Miller, just a little bobble back to the blue line. And for Tanev, he knows he has Miller going to the net, he just gets it there. And so many shots through all the traffic, through all this series, have not found their way in the back of the net. But this one here finds its way through everyone, including Alex Stalock, into the bottom of the net. And that's the celebration afterwards.
Only two goals during the regular season. And without a doubt, the biggest goal of his life right there. And 11 seconds is a magic number. The last playoff overtime winner for the Vancouver Canucks. Alex Burrows scored in the Stanley Cup final at the 11-second mark in game two.
Yeah, great shot there of everybody converging in on Tanev. Jacob Markstrom right there. Look at this. He gets going in a hurry to join into that pile in celebration. And Travis Green on the bench. That's the reaction of the coaching staff coming together. And unfortunately, in a situation like this, there's got to be that reaction as well, too. The Minnesota Wild with a valiant effort. Jim Benning with the celebration in the box, watching from atop.
Only 1 point separated these two teams during the regular season. We knew this would be hard fought. A lot of people thought it could go five, but Chris Tanev has other plans tonight. And the Canucks move on to the next round, and another team has been eliminated on Elimination Friday. Five teams are out in 1 day of the Stanley Cup playoffs. So once again, the final score and a thriller off this winner by Chris Tanev, 5-4 Vancouver.